Hey guys, this is Raiko for VGGameplay, and today we are playing Nano Assault Neo on the Wii U. Now, I know not too many of you out there have bought a Wii U, but for those of you who have, then you probably recognise this game, at least by title alone. This is one of the very early eShop titles, and you know what, it's pretty fun actually. It's got some mixed reviews, but it's definitely worth a go if you can get it on sale. It's not the biggest game out there, but it's definitely a satisfying one. Visually, it looks very good. It's just very simple and satisfying to play, really. So, anyway, we're going to play through the single player mode, the original mode, which is broken up into four different clusters. As you can see, we have Epsilon, Zeta, Omicron, and Sigma. We're going to play through them all in order. Each video is going to be each cluster, if I can play well enough. So here we go, here's the first one. Now this definitely isn't the best twin stick shoot 'em up I've played. That award goes to Geometry Wars 2 on the Xbox 360. I have put a ridiculous amount of time into that game, and it's got plenty of modes, so you can play that sort of game forever. Whoa. Right, basically, I am a capsule, I think, although it does look like a very tiny ship. And the idea here is to eradicate these cells of the Nanostray virus, which are all these freaky looking enemies. Ooh, nearly get taken out there. I'm going to try and do this without dying, but I must warn you, I'm not an expert at these games at all. You know, I just don't have the reflexes, and you know, these games are all about dodging, but I become a bit suicidal and sort of jump in, so apologies, you're not about to see the best gameplay for this game. Perhaps I'm not doing it justice, but I just wanted to share my impressions. So there we go, in the top left corner you can see my lives, I've got two of them, and just underneath is another statistic saying 92%. That's just telling me how much of the cell I've eradicated. Now, once you hit 90%, it opens up the exit, which is what I'm looking for at the minute. I believe it's there it is. It's that beam of light. I haven't really got much time to mess around. I'm just going to go for this, aren't I? Well, there we go. That's cell one of four of the first cluster. Basically, the aim is to eradicate all of the viruses. The Nanostray, I think they're called. Once you hit 90%, the exit opens, and that allows you to move on to the next stage. This here, the Nano Shop, this comes up between stages, and basically you can upgrade your sort of ship, your capsule. So we're gonna buy the Nano Gauge 2.0 because that increases the multiplier, which is good for a score. We're gonna buy the Attractor because it allows me to collect those green tokens, which you spend in this shop at the end of each round, so it's always worth getting those. I'm going to buy a satellite because it increases my firepower, and then we're going to leave. So yeah, that green token there, if you saw it, that's currency. You spend that on upgrading your capsule, and well, it makes things a hell of a lot easier. Now, I don't know about you, but I think this is, like, I want to say it's a gorgeous looking game, but it's sort of, it's disgusting. It looks disgusting, but at the same time, it looks really good. And Shin'en are pretty, I think they're pretty well known for that, really. They seem to make some really good looking games on Nintendo consoles. I wouldn't say they're the strongest developer out there, but they've done a really good job with this. I'd be proud to have this on the CD. Once again, if I take any hits, apologies, I'm not very good at these sort of games. They're just fun. Whoa! Get out of my face. You can see my multiplier in the top right corner is currently in the 6, 7, 8, sort of 9 area. The higher you get it, the bigger the score you're going to get with each kill. I've been ignoring all those tokens over there, so I'm going to try and find my way over to there. Oh, but I've gone the wrong way entirely. So that was worth it. Whoa! Get out of my face. Thank you. Oh, crap. I'm not going to get any of these tokens. We're at least going to get these a lot. Okay, that'll do. And that is cell 2. You can gamble at the end of each stage and try and go for the 100% sort of clearance. I'm not sure how much of a bonus you get for it. It's probably worth going for, but it's not something I achieve very often. So here we are, we're in the shop again. 950 credits, so I'm going to probably buy this Seca VR. This device emits an antimatter energy pulse that tracks, follows, and jumps to multiple enemy organisms until its energy is depleted. You know, that means nothing to me. I can remember each sort of special weapon visually, but in terms of description, well, I'd be useless at describing it, basically. I'm gonna get some of these tokens. Camera does go funny sometimes, which is a bit annoying. Like, whenever there's a sharp edge to a cell, it's very hard to see. Ooh, I just died. It's very hard to see what you're shooting at sometimes, and it's very hard to sort of judge where the bullets are coming from. That's probably my only complaint in terms of gameplay. Otherwise, you know, the bullets light up very well, and you can sort of judge the enemy's bullets as they're coming towards you, which is the most important thing in a game like this. Now, this might seem a little easy, and that's because it is. This is only the first cluster. Things do get ridiculously difficult as you go on. Oh, we've got these. I don't know what these are called, but they're quite cool. They're sort of invisible until you are up, until you start firing at them, in fact. There's another one. So I haven't used my special weapon at all yet. Let's give that a go. Oh yes, I remember that one. Honestly, it's worth using your special weapons when you get them. Especially when things, some of the later stages when it gets really difficult. And on the bigger enemies, preferably, you don't want to waste it on an enemy that can be killed really easily, as I run into some bullets. If all goes well, I'm going to try go for 100% on this stage. I haven't talked much about the gamepad, how that's implemented in this game. To be honest, it's not amazing. I mean, it's welcome. It's nice. You get a sort of plain overview of the entire map. And it's very good for reading where objects are that aren't on the screen, things like that. Jesus. See, at the moment the camera's being a bit of a pain. Now I'm on completely the wrong side of the cell. Never mind. Any more? Whoa, I didn't think we were going to be that big. Right, now all the enemies are on the opposite side of the screen. Or the cell, I should say. Come on, who's left? Oh, he's the other side of the wall. You can't see him on the screen, but on the gamepad he is the other side of that fungus tree looking thing. So I'm going to leave him. Oh well, not too bad. I think that's probably my highest score. Here we go, what can we buy? I've used a life, so I might pick up an extra life. The credit doubler doubles the amount of credits you pick up. It's useful, but it's something you want to buy early on. I've only got one more cell left, so there's no point buying that now because I don't get to go to the shop after the next stage. So what we're going to do instead, I'm either going to go for the extra life or I'm going to go for... I might go for the Seca again. I'm assuming that's how it's pronounced. It could be Seeker. It'd make more sense. Here we go. Trilidus. Looks like something out of Super Mario Galaxy in a way, like a more disgusting version of it. And as is the case with all four clusters, the final cell is always a sort of boss battle. And the idea here, all I'm doing, if you can visually see what's going on. It's destroying this creature's kneecaps. And the camera's gone a bit funny. But it's alright, I can still see. Whoa! This isn't a particularly challenging boss, there you go, done already. But as I say, it's the first cluster, and I'm glad to have got through that in one piece. There we go, Soul Purified. Final score of 1,000,000. Honestly, that's probably the best I've ever done. And there you go, that's cluster 1 of 4. I'm going to try and break these videos up into separate clusters, so hopefully, if you've enjoyed what you watched, you'll come and see me do Zeta in a moment. Thanks for watching, guys. I will see you next time.